Hi, my name is Carrie Saunders. I'm an account manager at Western Computer. Today I have Talca Clem, who is one of our senior payroll consultants, who will show you how to set up a payroll control.
Thank you, Carrie. My name is Talca Clem. I am a senior NAV consultant here at Western Computer. And we're going to walk through a scenario today of an employee that I've created. His name is Sam Redfern. He began working for us on June the 6th in 2016, and it's now 60 days later, and he's eligible for benefits that he wasn't eligible for the first 60 days. We want to add vacation and holidays to Sam. We want to allow him to start gaining our health insurance, and we want to enter him into the 401k program. Before we can do that, we need to set up a few things. We need to make sure that we have a pay control group set up to hold our benefit pay controls. And you can do this prior to any employees going on to these benefits, or you can do this at any time just to make it easier for you to add the pay controls to the employee. And also, HR should have entered Sam's rates when he was hired so that we already have that taken care of. But we'll double check it. To set up a pay control group, what this does is it allows us to have a grouping of pay controls that would be our 60-day benefits. I've got the 401k, both employee-employer, the vacation, the holidays he's going to start accruing or getting paid for, and then also our flex health benefit that he's going to be eligible for. After we have a pay control group set up, we can go to Sam, and we want to double check and make sure his rates are here. And the nice thing about our fact boxes on the right-hand side is we can get directly to those rates very quickly by pointing at the 4, turns blue, and I'll click there. We're going to see that we've got a 401k rate that would have started on 8/6 of 6%. Our flex health insurance is $1,200 a year, and this pay control is set up to actually distribute that across his pay frequency. And then our vacation, he's allowed 1 week. So we do have all his rates set up so that when we calculate his payroll, it will find these rates. So now just to set up him to be eligible for these pay controls, is very simple. Over here again to the right where our pay controls are stored, I can see that he currently has 17 controls eligible for him. If I click in there, you'll note that I don't have any of the vacation or the 401k, any of those pay controls yet. But I'm going to attach those so that they become active for Sam. I click on the icon that's called Attach Control Group. I'm going to get a process screen up. It's going to allow me to choose my 60-day benefit controls. I'm going to activate them. I want to be sure and skip any controls that he's already got activated, so I will leave that as skipped. My employee number is Sam, so I'm only affecting Sam Redfern. And I want to pull down to the bottom here, and under code for my pay control group, I'm going to choose my 60-day benefits. Click OK. And you're going to notice that now I have my holiday and my vacation and my health pay controls that have been added to Sam. Once you've added these and they are active, you want to double check and make sure they are active, because they're already part of our process in our master control, when I calculate, I will have those pay controls in my calculation. So here's an example of his calculation after I added those pay controls. I have one as a sample of what it looked like before I added it. You can see that he just has his regular hours, his regular earnings. Social Security is fit. His Texas SUI, his net pay was $704.29. for the same amount of hours, I now have a 401k, I have Flex Health, so forth and so on, so his net pay now becomes $645.03. So this is the difference between before and after we added his benefit pay controls. It's really an easy process to do through a pay control group. If you're only adding one, you can add it to Sam's pay controls directly to the screen, but you want to make sure you get it activated. But if there's multiple pay controls that need to be added for benefits or health insurance, 401k, things like that, I always like to do a group. It just makes it easier to attach that group. Hope this helps you go forward with your payroll. You can always contact Western Computer for further help.